Welcome back to phase three of the ADU ground up build series. I'm super excited to show everybody drywall. We're gonna talk about tape and texture, paint. We're gonna go over finish work, tile, flooring, cabinets, electrical finish. We're gonna get this ADU across the finish line, and I'm gonna show you all the little tips and tricks that you can use to either build your own ADU or at least understand what your contractor's billing you for.
Ready to buy your next rental?
You'll need a mortgage lender, but not just any lender, an award-winning mortgage lender. One that will support you throughout your entire home buying journey and not leave you second guessing whether or not you'll close on time. A lender like SoFi, our sponsor for today's video. With competitive rates, an excellent reputation, and zero origination fees, SoFi was named the best mortgage lender for saving money by CNBC Select. Plus, with SoFi's $5,000 on-time close guarantee offer, you can rest easy knowing that SoFi is dedicated to closing your home loan purchase on time. And with their dedicated mortgage loan officer support, you'll have less stress throughout the entire process. Visit SoFi.com/bigger-pockets for a commitment-free mortgage rate check without impacting your credit. Find the link in the description box or scan the QR code. That's SoFi.com/bigger-pockets. So drywall is one of my favorite steps of the ADU process. It's where you can really start to see the fruits of everybody's labor. This place is going to transform from a framed shell to what's going to look a lot more like a house in one day. Three guys are here. They showed up this morning, and by probably three or four, they'll have this whole place hung. They'll be back tomorrow to start tape and texture. So the drywall supply company is here, and they're going to unload this rock simply by using mechanical advantage here with the boom crane. Work smarter, not harder. These guys boom right on into the unit. The guys right now are making quick work of hanging this drywall. We're putting 5/8 on the ceiling and 5/8 on the garage wall, and everything else is half inch.
Putting in the work.
The drywallers are making this lid hang look easy. So you'll hear me talk about this often, but to build your own ADU, you need three things. You need the right instruction, the right tools, and the right mindset. And these three obviously have those. The drywall is hung. You can see the walls are done, the lid is done. The next step is gonna be to put a joint compound on all these factory seams and then go through with a paper tape. And this serves two purposes. One, it's gonna help make this wall more fire resistive. And two, it's gonna keep these seams from separating over time. After that compound is dry, it's gonna get sanded. The crew will come back and skim it a second time. After that second coat is sanded down, these walls will be ready for a nice hand texture. The hand texturing process gets very messy. You can see that there's paper down. If you're gonna use a concrete finish floor, or even if you're using a subfloor that you're gonna put some kind of product over, it's nice to put paper down so you don't have to go through with a floor scraper and scrape all that dry mud off of your sub deck. Here's some basic sheetrock anatomy. Obviously, we have the wall board here. This is a flat paper tape, and then we have an angled tape on this inside 45-degree corner. And then on the corners of our windows, these three-way wraps, we're using a metal sharp corner trim. You can also use a rounded bullnose, but because of the contemporary style, we opted with a sharp look on all these corners. Tape and texture going in right now. He's using a machine called a bazooka that applies mud and tape to the corners all in one shot. You can see some really interesting equipment here. He's walking around on stilts so he doesn't have to move a ladder around as he finishes off this vault. What kind of tool is this that you're using?
An angle box.
An angle box. You just fill it up with mud and run it, huh?
Yeah.
Second coat of top going over the tape joints right now. It's imperative that we get these really smooth so the hand texture doesn't show any deflections in the wall.
Concrete crew is here and they're pouring this approach. That's a street board they're using. They drag that across both forum boards on each side. The guys in front are raking the mud out, and they'll put a hard finish on this after it's all filled in. concrete guys are here today. We have good weather with no rain. They're screeding. That's a screed board they're using to level the concrete apron.
Here's the tool cut. Right now they're putting brake lines in this concrete. We put these in so the slab has a spot that it's going to fracture. We can control the crack line.
Now that it's starting to set up, they're putting a hard trowel finish on it.
Now that this place is textured and the texture is dry, the finished carpenters are on site. They've set up here in the great room and they're gonna be doing windowsills, aprons, they're hanging all the doors, they're gonna be doing the closet packs, and then some of the work will be done after the floor is installed. They'll come back and run all the baseboard and do turnkey, add the hardware. We're gonna be using a paint grade MDF trim in here. You've got two options on your accessory dwelling unit for trim packages. You can use stain grade, which is gonna cost a little bit more money and be harder to finish, and paint grade, which comes pre-primed. The paint crew will come in and fill all the holes and paint over it. Paint grade trim is a lot more forgiving because you can caulk and putty the holes and hide mistakes that you make. To save money and keep this accessory dwelling unit affordable, we're gonna be using hollow core doors. So they're about half the price as a solid core door. These are nice three panel shaker style doors with a dark hardware, which is on trend at this time. There are several different techniques to paint the trim within your unit, but what we're doing here is going through with the trim color and shooting all of the casework, all the door trim, all the window sills. They set up all the doors in the great room and shot those individually. They'll shoot all the baseboard on sawhorses, and then they'll come back and mask the casework and paint the body. So one of the best ways to save money on your project is to paint your own ADU. Inside, they're gonna paint this thing. It's gonna cost about $3,000 to paint it. You can probably do it yourself for about $600 of paint. The exterior job is another $3,000 to $4,000. You can probably do that for about $1,500 of primer, paint, caulking, supplies. So don't be afraid to try to DIY parts of your project to save money. And painting is one of those that most DIY homeowners can do. They had a makeshift paint booth set up in the great room here where they sprayed all the doors. They're getting ready to shoot the inside of this. As you can see, everything's prepped. They've done the trim color. They're gonna come back through now and shoot the body. If you're gonna paint your own interior and you have a vaulted ceiling, make sure to grab a gun extension like we're using here. So the paint crew showed up today. You can see behind me, they prepped this unit. They're ready to paint it. We have to be really careful in this climate because if it freezes overnight, we run the risk of the surfactants in the paint bleeding through. And if that happens, we'll have to wash this house down with soap and water and repaint it. So pay particular attention to the manufacturer's instructions on your paint and your climate. Make sure to pay close attention to overspray. Paint's gonna stick on everything in the surrounding areas. So move your cars and trucks, put drop cloths down on anything you don't want painted, just like the patio here. Now that the paint's complete and all the masking has been taken down, we can start finish work. So the tile crew showed up today. They set up shop right here in the front room and they're tiling the bathrooms. The electricians are also here doing some finish work, putting in outlets and switches. The cabinets are being made currently and they should be getting dropped off soon. A good way to set yourself apart in your rental market is by using real hard surfaces. So these bathrooms are both real tile. This is a ceramic 12 by 24. It's only a few dollars a square foot and a little bit more labor, and you'll really stand out against other people who are using maybe a sheet vinyl or even an LVP. So consider real tile in your ADU bathrooms. Here's the cement underlayment underneath the tile. It's been installed and then also floated. And then in this bathroom right next door, the tile's in. This is a 12 by 24. With a random third brick lay. All the lighting fixtures are in, the fans are up, switches, switch plate covers, all electrical trim is done. A really nice upgrade that goes a long ways is putting dimmer switches on your lighting. A lot of rentals don't have that, so if you put dimmers on your switches, maybe $15 or $20 more per switch times three or four switches in the house, you'll really stand out. Coming by to check on progress of this project, and the cedar is in. Talk about a beautiful look. So the painters went with a bright white on this, and then they pre-finished those clear cedar shingles for the gables and just installed them. What a clean look. remember to put a conduit chase underneath your slabs and or sidewalks. So later on, when you go to run irrigation or low voltage lighting wires, you already have a clear path underneath concrete.
Cabinets are one major expense in your project. Depending on your market or your builder's style, you may or may not install the cabinets over hardwood. Here in our region, we like to set them up on blocks to the finished height of the floor and install them first. The last thing that's gonna go in is the floor, so we don't do any scratches or any damage to the product.
You're good, howdy.
I do see a lot of people try to go to a box store and buy modular cabinets and put them together and make them work. And what I've found over almost 30 years is that it's actually cheaper to hire a local custom cabinet maker and have them come out and measure. They'll deliver the cabinets, they'll install them. It's usually not much more than buying box store crap. That's been my experience. Let your end user dictate the actual finished package that you use in your unit. Here, this is gonna be a rental, so we wanna go with a nice heavy-duty cabinet with a hardwood box, full extension drawers, because these are gonna get a lot of use. A lot of times when people try to save money with a cheaper design, they just end up having to come back later and repair it. It's really easy to not get enough storage space within your accessory dwelling unit, so we always try to go with big, deep cabinets. A 24-inch deep cabinet over the fridge is imperative. There's nothing worse than a little 12-inch cabinet that you can't reach. And then these big pantry spaces will go a long ways when we don't have a ton of space. When it comes to picking a floor for your ADU, there's a ton of choices out there. You can use hardwood, you could use laminate, you could use LVP. Obviously, we did tile in the bathrooms here because we want something that's gonna be waterproof and hard. On this floor, we decided to go with something a little bit more affordable. There's a large variance in pricing in flooring. You can pay anywhere from 99 cents all the way up to $8 or $10 a square foot. So have a good plan, understand what your end user wants, and then take action. Getting so close on this one here. The finished carpenter showed back up today. The plumber's here doing some trim. Probably, another couple of days, and this place will be ready to be cleaned and we'll be able to do our final walkthrough. Let's go take a look at what everybody's doing right now. This is the storm before the calm. It's just about wrapped up in here, and this is when the house is almost the messiest. Appliances were just delivered. The countertops are in. Finishing up the vent hood. The finished carpenters are back today to do turnkey and install appliances. Lay the baseboard down over the seams here where this laminate meets the wall. Beautiful Douglas fir door here is stained and ready to go in. Another probably 40 hours and this place will be completed. Coming close to the finish line on this unit. Super exciting, bright white. The painters are here today just doing final touch up. They're filling the holes on the baseboard, caulking the top of that, and then hitting any smudges or any areas that were damaged by other subcontractors. You have to build that into your paint plan. There's always gonna be small repairs. There's gonna be scuffs. There's gonna be little drywall patches that need to be repainted. So the last few days of the job here, there's a lot of work going on. We're really excited to show you the finished product. A real quick special thank you to the team at Suncrest for making this build possible. We are beyond excited to pass final inspection. Make sure to tune in on the final video of this series where we go over the costs. We're gonna do a complete walkthrough. We're gonna talk about the timeline, and we're also gonna cover how we find great tenants. You can use our criteria. I'm gonna share it all. We'll see you on the next video.